So, Myron Harvey O'Neill was born September 22nd, 1935, in Ainsworth, Nebraska, to Harvey and Myrna Johnston O'Neill. The family lived in Rock, Brown, and Saline counties of Nebraska, and also in Washington and Oregon states. In 1949, falling in the eighth grade, that's as far as Ed went to school, he began working on ranches, and then he settled with Bud and Rose White family by Rose. And then in 1954, he joined the United States Army. He served in the Korean War. On December 23rd, 1956, Dad and Mom were united in marriage. He was united in marriage to Beverly Tucker at Rose, Nebraska. The couple lived in St. Louis before returning to Nebraska in 1959. That's where Brother Terry was born, was in St. Louis. And they survived the big tornado that went through St. Louis. They were in an apartment complex, and so God is always gracious. And then they moved back to Ainsworth, and then in 1962, after I was born, they lived in Ainsworth, and I was born in Burwell, and we moved to Valley County, west of Ord, and they moved me out of the sand hills, and they got my feet stuck in the mud, and I've been here ever since. I guess today I pray to be nice to have a little mud. And then in 1965, the dad worked various jobs, and then in 65 he bought his first truck and started moving mobile homes. And if any of you have ever met a 16 by 80 on the road, you know that that takes a little patience and skill to maneuver those things. And his dad was a man of many talents and much patience. And later in life, with the help of the VA, Dad did get his high school diploma. And as everybody knows, he was a well-known musician. And if you notice, he didn't really pick up the fiddle till later in life. He played the banjo because he couldn't quite drive his truck and play the fiddle at the same time. Play his banjo and drive the truck. So, and when we were kids growing up, every TV show you thought he was watching Deliverance because it had banjo music in the background. Played with Billy Weber and Casey Damrotowski and Mike Kuschak. A lot of those people got to play with him in the dance band. And then he played in the Fun Bunch with everybody. And he got inducted into the Old Time Music Hall of Fame, which the certificates back there. We went to Iowa for that ceremony, and when Bob Everhart had him on a stage and presented him the certificate, he asked Dad, he said, why do you feel that you were nominated and deserve to be inducted? And Dad, in his humbleness, said, "Well, I'll play with anybody, and I'm easy to get along with." And of course, everybody knows about his special love for dogs. Skippy, Streeter, and Sparky, to name a few. Survivors include myself, Rod O'Neill of Burwell, daughter-in-law Denise O'Neill of Ward, five grandchildren and their spouses, Tyler O'Neill, Travis and Catherine O'Neill, Timber and Tyler Crumrine, Clinton O'Neill and Darcy O'Neill, three great-grandchildren, Trayton, Kaya, Katrina Cassell, a brother and sister-in-law, Harold and Pam O'Neill of Salt Lake City, Utah, and a brother-in-law and two sisters-in-law, Bruce and Linda Tucker of Waverly and Marcella Tucker of Raleigh, North Carolina. He was preceded in death by his parents, my mother Beverly, who passed away November 24th, 2014, and Dad passed away one day before that. Was it 5 years or six? Anyway, so his son Terry O'Neill, daughter-in-law Wendy Jo O'Neill, and infant brother Clyde, his sister Rhonda Bennett, another brother Norm O'Neill, and three brothers-in-law, Jerry, Bill, and Dan Tucker. In Proverbs, the 23rd Proverbs, this 15th verse, it says, "My son, if your heart is wise, then my heart will be glad indeed. My inmost being will rejoice when your lips speak what is right. Do not let your heart envy sinners, but always be zealous for the fear of the Lord. There is surely a future hope for you, and your hope will not be cut off. Listen, my son, and be wise, and set your heart on the right path. Listen to your father, who gave you life, and do not despise your mother when she is old." And some of the things that my dad, some of the things I remember really clearly, especially when I was a kid, he said, "You know, you might be able to fool me, you might be able to fool even the law," and he says, "you can't fool God and gravity." So, you know, he tried to, he was right. And another thing he always told me, says, "just don't get in over your head." Well, that doesn't take very tall water for me to get in over my head. But I just really thank everybody for coming, and after we get done, we have a lot of food downstairs, and just hope that everybody will stay in fellowship, and we're going to have some music, and then we're going to eat, and then we're just hoping that all of us good music friends will stay and play and just jam like they would if he was here. So God bless you and thank you.